Alright, my man, state your name and let them know you on Real Talk with Nick.
My name is Ronald Robinson, aka Rondo Glows. My YouTube channel, subscribe if you know what I'm saying.
And you on Real Talk with Nick?
Yes, sir. I'm on Real Talk with Nick.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up. That's what it's all about right now, man. Are you a Nick fan?
Yes, sir.
Okay, man. I know the viewers will be happy knowing that you're a Nick fan. This is Nick content. I don't just interview Nick fans. I interview disappointed Nick fans.
Yeah.
Some of you disappointed Nick fans claim y'all not Nick fans, but y'all are still Nick fans just waiting for the right opportunity to jump aboard, man.
Yes, sir.
I say stay on the train, baby.
Yeah, stay on the train. You got to stay loyal because I guarantee you, one of these seasons we going to pop.
Yeah, and it's soon, man.
Yeah,
it's real soon, man. Listen, man, so you're a Knicks fan. Who's your favorite player on the Knicks, man?
I have to say R.J. Barrett, man.
Yeah?
R.J., yes, sir.
Wow, I'm not surprised, man. You would mention that player's name. What you like about his game?
I just like that he, what's a part about him, even when he has bad games, he just don't give up. Like, he'll have a bad first half and then come in the second half and just forget about the first half and play lights out. And he has that mentality, like, don't worry about what happened. You know what I'm saying? Don't dwell on what happened. Negativity. Just focus on the next play, the next, you know, everything. Just the
so
next.
You're saying he's headstrong.
Yes, sir. And okay. I feel like he's about to have a breakout season, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Because I know it's a lot of people that's like, oh, he not Zion Williamson. He not John Morant. But everybody's not going to pop the first couple seasons.
Some people say he got a better all-around game than Ja Morant.
Yeah, he does. He's a better shooter. But I'm not taking that from Ja Morant, but R.J. Barrett is that guy, I feel like. He's about to be that guy. He's about to have a breakout season.
Would you compare him to other players? Like, is there another player that you say, you know, R.J. Barrett remind me of this player? Or
I'll say he'll be a better shooting Jimmy Butler. I feel like he'll be a better three-point shooting Jimmy Butler. I feel like that would be his ceiling.
The ceiling?
Yeah, I feel like that's the ceiling. I feel like his floor, I don't know what his floor may be. His floor, I'd say probably like, I don't even know what his floor would be like. Cause I think he's going to reach his ceiling. I don't even think he's going to lower expectations.
Think he's going to become an all-star one day?
Almost definitely. I feel like he could become, like, if he gets his free throw percentage up, because I forgot what he shot last year. I think it was like in the low 70s. If he get that up to 80, he could average like 24, 25 points a game, because he averaged 20 points on low efficiency. If he gets his efficiency up, I feel like he could average 24, 25 points a game easily and become an all-star. That's what I feel like.
Okay, moving right along, man. Julius Randle, bro. Mm-hmm.
Julius Randle.
What do we do with him, man? Are you high on Julius Randle? Do you give him another year this upcoming season to get back on board and win the fans over?
I will say this. I'll give him a half of this season to get it together. Like, I know we got a point guard now in Jalen Brunson. We got a point guard. Now he don't have to bring the ball up, play point forward and all that. You don't have to. I don't want to see him bringing the ball up. He needs to be in a post.
Right.
Do what he do. He's a big guy. You know what I'm saying? He's a power forward. So you got to be in a post and all that. You don't got to be shoot. You can shoot the three, but you don't got to do step back threes and all that. You don't need to. That's not his game.
That's not his game. So speaking of him bringing the ball up, right? Do you think he did that because he had to? Or is that his game? Where he plays out of position?
I feel like in the season when we had Elfrid Payton as the point guard, I feel like he might have had to do that. So I'll give him that, but this past season, I feel like he didn't need to do that, because you see how the way they switched, I think it was like January, they switched and ran the offense around R.J. Barrett. I feel like they should have bended that, to be honest. They should have bended that, because you drafted R.J. third overall, and I feel like we probably would have won more games if we switched made R.J. Barrett the first option sooner, to be honest. But
really?
And I feel like he's going to be the first option this season, to be honest. If we don't get Donovan Mitchell. If we get Donovan Mitchell.
Hold on to that. We're going to get to that. Don't jump the gun. You know, that's the big splash.
Okay,
you know?
Okay.
I want to see how deep you can swim. I got more questions for you, man. All
right, cool.
I got tidal waves of questions, man, before we dive deep. So you basically saying Julius Randle, he need to take a back seat.
Yeah, I feel like he should. I really feel like he should.
Okay. Do you think he's going to be a Cancer when we speak. Is he going to be a Cancer this season? Because you mentioned Jalen Brunson. Man, listen, I'm going to get right to it. Some Knicks fans don't even think Julius Randle still want to remain in New York.
Well, if he don't, they could easily trade it to a smaller market because, look, I feel like if you can't play here, if it's not for you, that's okay. This is New York City. You know what I'm saying? It's New York City. If it's not for you, you could go to a smaller market and ball out.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to give him half of this season. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what he gets by the All-Star break, man. I could say something.
Did you see his conditioning? Like his body weight? He lost a lot of weight.
Yeah. So that's important. That's why I want to hold on to him to see what he can do at the trade deadline.
Think it's possible that he lost too much weight?
Nah.
Do you like his size? You like his condition?
Yeah, I do because now I feel like he can play defense better and he won't be gassed. I've seen a lot of times during last season he was gassed. Because Tibbs play these guys like 40 plus minutes, especially his best players. And he was gassed. You see him walking up the court, not getting back on defense because he's tired.
Okay. And speaking of players being gassed, when you got a coach like Tom Thibodeau, who some say, a lot of say, he work his players to the ground. You think he's the right coach for the Knicks, man? Are you high on Thibs?
I feel like this season will tell me a lot. The past two seasons, like especially this past season, I was very disappointed in the rotations. I was very disappointed because I feel like he did go to the young guys, but not enough. Because you see the Kemba experiment didn't work. Then you had, Evan Fournier. You just had all the best that was like. And he played Alec Burks at the point. Like, come on now. Like, that didn't make much sense. You could have went with anybody else than Alec Burks. He's not a point guard. His job is to get buckets. His job is not to facilitate. He didn't even do nothing.
You're not hiring Alec Burks?
Not at point guard. I feel like he's a good bucket getter. Not at point guard. He's not a point guard.
So what position you think he's...
I feel like, how tall is he? Like about 6'6", 6'7"?
Yeah.
I feel like he could be like a shooting guard to get you some buckets off the bench, something like that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
All right. I want to mix it up a little and talk about players that we let go. Was you disappointed that they let go Alfred Payton? You think Alfred Payton got the short end of the stick?
Nah. There was no space for him on this team. He did everything. He was with us for like about a couple years, 2-3 years. He wasn't gonna do nothing. He needs to be like on a team where it's like a maybe like a contender. Like where he is at Phoenix, I feel like that's a good place for him because he don't have to do too much. We just got one job to do, which is play defense, and that's it. Nothing's gonna be expected from him. He played in New York, of course. People gonna expect from the starting point guard. He's gonna expect a lot from him.
Okay.
So I feel like he's good for where he's at.
Another player we let go, Reggie Bullock. You think that was a mistake?
That might have been a mistake. I'm not gonna lie because. Yeah, Evan Fournier is a great shooter, but Reggie Bullock, that defense. We need those defenders, man. Like, you see the way, like, the defense, like, we was 11th in defense last season, but the season before, we was, like, I think it was second or third. Like, even though 11th's not too bad, but that's a huge drop off. But I felt like he was a big loss for us. I'm not going to lie. He was a big loss for us.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nerlens Noel, another person we let go.
Nerlens Noel, I feel like the injuries was catching up to him. If he didn't get hurt as much, I feel like I would miss him, but he was hurt too much last season.
Yeah.
I feel like and you see the way like he would block shots and just like fall down, like that's a little bit concerning for me. So I'm not gonna miss him. I'm not gonna lie.
All right. And last but not least, man, Kemba Walker, man. What happened? We all thought, Kemba Walker being the man from New York.
Mm-hmm.
We thought he was going to put his stamp here. He looked like he wanted to be here.
Mm-hmm.
Rumors to have it is that Tom Thibodeau wasn't high on him because he didn't play defense.
Mm. I feel like we should have got him like about 3 years ago, man. I feel like we should have got him 3 years ago when he was 3 years younger and when he didn't have these knee problems. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got him when he had a bunch of knee problems. Of course, you're not gonna be able to play defense like that no more, cause his knees are like shot. You can't do that no more. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, he could score the ball here and there, but defense wins championships. And if you don't defend, you could score as many points as you want, but if you don't defend and let the other team score, you're not gonna win. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Now you said something quite interesting. You said defense wins championships, right? You believe that wholeheartedly, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. So when we speak of a point guard, right? Like Jalen Brunson, is he a defensive player?
Is he a defensive player? I wouldn't say he's a defensive stopper, but I will say Tom Thibodeau, he's a defensive coach, right? And I feel like he can motivate these guys that's not really like a defensive stopper, but they have to want it though. You know what I'm saying? Like you can tell somebody something as much as you want, but they have to want it. And I feel like Jalen Brunson is that type of person that he's gonna want to defend. And he's gonna wanna, you know, just go all out for the team. I see it. Like, and yeah, we might have paid him a little bit too much, but that's all right.
You think that's so? Right, you think 104 million is a lot?
Maybe for a person that hasn't been an all-star yet, I would say that. That's a little bit too much, but I feel like he's gonna be worth it. To be honest,
I feel
like he's gonna be worth it. Yeah.
You think he's undersized?
Maybe a little bit, but I feel like heart over height, you could defend against anybody, to be honest.
Ooh, I like that analogy. You said heart over height.
Heart over height, because...
And that's what you think Jalen Brunson possesses.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I feel like he can, and I feel like Tom Thibodeau will bring that out of him. And I feel like this season is going to motivate him to be an even better defender.
Okay. Is it possible that we might get another Derrick Rose situation from Tom Thibodeau working over Jalen Brunson, where he might... overwork him.
I feel like that.
Because Derrick Rose was that dude at one time under Tom Thibodeau.
Right. I feel like he needs to, like, in order for us to have a successful season, he needs to spread the minutes out, like, more, to be honest. Like, you can't, because this is a long season, man. And then you got, like, if we make the playoffs, that's another game we have to play. So I feel like he has to spread the minutes fairly, to be honest. Like, you can't run these guys into the ground because that's how people get hurt. You see the way RJ got hurt at the end of the season, he had a little ankle injury. That was because of Tibbs. I think I don't know what game it was. He was either down or up big, and he still left RJ in the game and he got hurt. You can't do that. You know what I'm saying? You really can't do that because you're going to get these guys hurt, and we need these players. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's why we have a bunch of players on the team. You don't need to be playing like game 70s, 71, 72. We don't need these guys to play real, real big minutes if we're in the playoff pitch. If we like the 6-5 seed by the end, by like game 70, you don't need to play these guys big, big, big minutes like that. You need to spread it out so they can rest for the playoffs. You know what I'm saying?
Right, makes sense.
You know what I'm saying? So they're going to be burnt out.
Okay, and moving right along, man, you quickly, man. He was in the backcourt under the tutelage of Derrick Rose. Some thought he was the next man up to fulfill that vacancy when we speak of the point guard position. How do you feel like that? Because quickly played point guard in Kentucky.
Right. I feel like...
Is he better off in the two-guard position? Combo guard?
I feel like he could be a combo.
He is the combo.
I feel like he can...
But should he remain?
Yeah, I feel like he should remain. I feel like he could play either or. I feel like he could play off the ball, be a shooting guard, or he could be the point guard. It's whatever he's asked to do. I feel like he'll just adapt to any situation he's in.
And what you like about his game when speaking for Manuel quickly?
I like the way that he, like, you know, the way, like, his three-point shooting is very important to this team, like, especially that long-range shooting. You know what I'm saying? That long-range three ball. I feel like he, you know, he's gotten a lot better with his playmaking, too. Like, the last 10 games of the season, we saw a good improvement of his playmaking. And I seen that he played in a pro-am league or whatever that is. His handle got a lot better, I see. So that's going to be very important this upcoming season. His handle's better, which means he can create for other people and create better for himself. So I'm really high on Emmanuel quickly.
Does he remind you of another player? I mean, his idol is Lou Williams.
Yeah. I feel like he could be, like, sort of a Lou Williams. I feel like he really can be. Like, especially, like, that score coming off the bench. You know what I'm saying? Or he could start. It don't even matter. He could do either or. But, like, I probably prefer him coming off the bench because we need that scoring. I feel like that scoring off of the bench is really important, especially in the playoffs that definitely in your bench.
You think he got what it takes to become the sixth man of the year?
Almost definitely. Most of it, like, because I feel like he's not too far off from Jordan Clarkson. You know, he was a sixth man of the year. I'm not sure if it was this past year or the year before. I feel like he's not too far from Tyler Hero, to be honest. I know Tyler Hero won Sixth Man of the Year last season. So I feel like he's not too far away from those guys. Like, he's not, like, they're not significantly that much better than Emmanuel. I feel like he can get to those guys' level.
What would you rate Emmanuel Quickly as a combo guard in the league? What
as
would you rate him?
As like 1 through 10?
Yeah, 1 to 10. Let's start there.
I feel like right now I'll give him like a good 6, 7.
Yeah.
6-7. I feel like he has the potential to be like top 5.
Yeah. Do you got him above Maxi?
I'm not gonna lie, like in their matchups, I feel like Quickly be getting a better Maxi sometimes. Cause you see he be crossing him over, making fours.
Yeah, so yeah. They're pointing him down.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know, man. I feel like right now, Maxi's a little bit better, maybe just a little bit, but I feel like they might be at the same level in their careers, to be honest. I feel like they play similar. You know what I'm saying? They play similar roles in their team. So we just gonna have to wait and see what happens. But I'm really high on Manu Quickly, and I'm really excited about all the young guys this season, because this season I feel like we're gonna do something big. I feel like we're gonna shock the whole league. We're gonna shock a lot of people. They sleeping on us now, but we used to that, so I'm ready for the season.
Oh, man, me and you both, man. And my man, Obi Kenobi, man.
Toppin.
Yeah, Obi Toppin. Some say he's only good for fast breaks. What do you say to those people?
I don't feel like he's only good for fast breaks. I feel like he just needs to get an opportunity. He needs to get, like, minutes to, like, you know, just show what he can do. We saw what happened. I think it was, like, literally the last game of the season.
When Julius Randle had the shoulder injury?
Yeah. We saw he scored 42 points. That's not just something that's out of thin air. I feel like he's really that, like, if he gets the opportunity, if he gets that many minutes, I feel like he can do that. You know what I'm saying? I feel like he could score maybe 20 a game. He just got to get the opportunity to get it. But I know that it's going to be hard because Tibbs likes to play Julius Randle so much. But you can't do that. You got to somehow split the minutes between the two. Like, you could give Julius Randle maybe, I say, I want to say maybe 28 to 30 minutes and then give the rest to Obi Toppin. I feel like that would be better because, let me tell you something, if Obi Toppin gets a lot of minutes, he's going to shock a lot of people, and I feel like he's going to play very well. Like, and I feel like some people, they have some concerns about his defense. I feel like he's getting better, though. He's really getting better. I feel like he made some good strides last season, and I come coming into this season, you got to give these people time to get better. You know what
you
I'm
think
saying?
You play great off the ball?
Off the ball. I feel like, yeah. I feel like he has the potential to play great off the ball. As in, you know, cutting, moving around screens or whatever, something like that, screening people. I feel like he has the potential to do all that.
Okay.
You know
and Mitchell Robinson, man. Mitchell the Robinson. Big man, man. Are you high on Mitch, man? He got the 60 mil extension contract.
The only thing I'm concerned about, he just has this. If he stays healthy, he's going to be a problem. I can tell you that right now. That's the only thing I don't like about Mitch is that he gets hurt a little bit too much for my liking. But if he stays healthy, he's a problem. He has the potential to be Rudy Gobert, to be honest. Rudy Gobert's not that much better than Mitch, if you think about it, because what else can Rudy Gobert do that Mitch can't? You know what I'm saying?
What about Clint Capella?
I feel like he could be on the same level as him, too, because these are guys that they don't really have an offensive game other than lobs and dunks, really. You don't ever see them really doing a post move or anything like that, or shooting the three ball. You don't really ever see that. So I feel like Mitch could get to those guys' level easily, most definitely.
Yeah.
He just got to stay healthy, and then he'll be good.
And he'll be good.
Mm-hmm.
All right, man, all right. And Derrick Rose, of course.
Derrick
Do you
Rose.
Think Derrick Rose still got some game left in him?
Well, most definitely. It's all about just staying healthy. Like, if he stays healthy, we're going to be definitely a playoff team. I see it. Because you see what he did in the playoffs, he was our only source of playmaking. Like, when Julius Randle didn't have it, and you already know Julius Randle, and then RJ Barrett wasn't quite ready yet at that time because he wasn't, like, the focal point of the offense. He was playing second fiddle to Julius Randle for all of the season. So he was pretty much just standing in a corner shooting three, so RJ Barrett wasn't really that ready at that time. But Derrick Rose, he was the only source of offense and playmaking we had at that time. So I feel like he definitely got some game left in him. He's only about 33, 34. He still got some game left in him. I'm not giving up on Derrick Rose.
And Quentin Grimes, man.
Quentin Grimes, man. You see, this is why, like, I love all our young players, man. I feel like they have so much potential, like especially Quentin Grimes. I feel like he can be a Klay Thompson. I might get some backlash for that. But if you see
Klay
the way,
Thompson, you're going to have to elaborate more on that.
If you see the way Klay Thompson played when he first came in the league, he played just like Quentin Grimes. He was a defensive guy that catches, shoot threes. And I feel like Quentin Grimes can be that because you see the way he shoot the ball is quick. You know what I'm saying? And he's going to keep getting better and better and better, to be honest. And I feel like he's such a great defender that we need on this team. I feel like his game is modeled by Klay Thompson, to be honest. Like, that tough defensive guy. Like, Klay Thompson might not be the defender he once was because of the injury, but that tough defensive guy is, you can't leave open, you can't leave Quentin Grimes open. Because he's going to keep shooting. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I see some Klay Thompson there. That's just me, though.
All right. You know, that's a good analogy, man. I hope the fruitation comes to that.
Yes.
Where you see the fruit of his labor when you speak of Quentin Grimes getting it in on the court. And Jericho Sims, man. Is he that guy to back up Mitch?
Yeah.
Is he like a good backup center?
I feel like, yeah, he could. You know, he's learning a lot. You know, we just re-signed him, like, to a guaranteed deal now. So he got a season under his belt, played in summer league, he played good. You know what I'm saying? So everything is just got to realize these are young men. They play in the NBA for the first time. They just got to learn a lot. And they will learn, I feel like. And I feel like Jericho Simpson, he's going to be a good backup center.
Backup center, you think?
For sure.
And this is the big talk, man. Everybody anticipating, we waiting on to see what's going to happen. DM! DM!
Tell you right
the
now.
Direct message guy, right? You know how to say, yo, don't be in my DMs. Some people want to be, they want to have you in their DMs when we speak of a player like Mitchell Robinson.
Right.
Talk to me, man. Is Mitchell Robinson that guy, man? Not Mitchell Robinson, Dominic Mitchell, man. Dominic Mitchell, is he that guy, man?
You know, there's some people that say, oh, you know, Donovan Mitchell's a star, and this, that, and the third.
Some say he's not a star yet. He's a star to be. I hear it all.
He's a superstar to me. I'm sorry. Like, I understand, you know.
What has he done in Utah for you to consider him a superstar?
A superstar? This is a guy that he's upped his play every single year. We've seen it from his first year in the league. Beating Russell Westbrook in the OKC Thunder as a rookie, that's not normal. Second round, he went toe-to-toe with James Harden. Then second year, he had a little bit of step back. But third year, he got even stronger, became an all-star. Then he's just gotten better and better every season. Yeah, you know, Utah hasn't been able to get over the hump. But look at the team that's surrounding him. You know what I'm saying? If you bring him here, I feel like he's going to have a way. And the West is just tough. Let's just keep it real. The West is, like, tough. You know, you got a bunch of tough teams in the West.
Does
he play defense? I feel like under a defensive coach, he will. And he will have the motivation, too. Because you got to think about it. You got to have the motivation to want. And I feel like Tom Thibodeau, he's going to put that in these guys' heads. Say, if you want to win this game, you better play some defense. And I feel like everybody's going to play defense this year. I don't know what it is. I don't know if I'm just being overly positive. But I feel like Tom Thibodeau's going to get in these guys' heads and make them play defense. And I feel like Donovan Mitchell, he can play some defense. Even though, like, sometimes, you know, he look a little bit suspect on defense. But I feel like he has the potential to play some defense.
Now, you got to be tricky. You got to be real cautious, man. Swimming in deep waters when I ask you this question, man. Who would you trade? Who would you give up for Donovan Mitchell?
Would I give up? I'm not gonna lie, I would love to keep, if we can, I would love to keep Obi and IQ. If I have to give away Grimes, I'll have to give away somebody, I'll have to give away Grimes. Because you gotta give up something. I would give up probably Grimes.
What about McBride? Would you give him up?
I might have to. Because the point guard spot is too, it's crowded right now. So I'll give up those two. I might, but maybe for the salaries to work, I'll have to give up Evan Fournier. I'm gonna just have to give him up. Those three, I'm not gonna like it, but I might have to give up Cam and maybe 3 to 4 first rounders and maybe a second.
Damn, you Shit, Danny Ainge would love you if you was in the fucking front office, man. Because, man, the players you willing to give up. Some say, yo, you making the bench weak, man. You making the starting five would be strong, but you giving up players that could potentially.
But yeah, but we still gonna have a backup center in Hardstown. We still gonna have Obi. We still gonna have Quickly off the bench. We could fill some players up with the bench. We could fill some of those because there's really no space for that I know. Unless you give up, you're gonna have to get rid of Evan Fournier to keep Cam because there's no space for Cam right now. You know what I'm saying? So you're either gonna have to, like, I won't give up Cam. I'm not gonna lie. I don't want to give up Cam, but they might want him. You know what I'm saying? But I'll definitely give up Grimes, McBride, Fournier to make the salaries work. 3 to 4 first round picks, and I might throw in Cam. I might. Okay. I won't like it, but I might.
All right. And some say you bring in Donovan Mitchell, he'll attract more players to want to play. Who? What superstar will come? That's the big question. Right. Who?
Because I feel like every superstar is really locked up in their contracts right now. I feel like there's nobody that's a free agent other than probably Jaylen Brown, in a couple of years. I think next year he's going to be a free agent. But other than him, I don't see anybody else. Everybody's locked in with their team. So I don't know what other superstar, because you're going to have to trade for somebody, but you can't trade nothing else. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what other superstar will be available.
All right.
Come in as a free agent other than Jaylen Brown. I would love to have Jaylen Brown. Sure.
And last but not least, man, can Donovan Mitchell play off the ball?
Most definitely. I feel like he can. I feel like he definitely can. I feel like he's a combo guard. He can either play point guard or shooting guard. And he can run around the screens, cut. The same way RJ can. I feel like RJ can play off the ball as well. I feel like it's going to be no problem with him fitting on the scene.
Some are afraid that he might iso the ball and hurt the development of our youth players. Because if the ball is always in his hand, how can players like Obi develop, Manu Quickly? I mean, you know.
I feel like
Is he going to want the ball in his hands,
yeah,
man?
Yeah, he will, but I feel like he's not going to be, he not, especially coming into a new situation, into a place he wants to be, I feel like he's not going to be selfish. I feel like he's going to take the shots that he's going to need to take at times. But I feel like everybody gonna share the wealth, man. I really do, because this is his home. He wants to be here, and I feel like he's gonna share the ball. I really do.
Right,
he averaged about 4 to 5 assists a game. I feel like there's no reason to make me think that he's not gonna share the ball with others. I really don't.
All right, my man. That's what it is, man. I want to thank my man for coming on Real Talk with Nick in the heart of Harlem. As y'all can see, he's NBA geared out, y'all. He's ready. He's ready, man.
Sorry, I got to get that RJ Barrett jersey, you know what
I'm saying? Man, you better get it before me. Yeah. Might be one left. We out, kid.